In this video, we're presented with a fairly simple trig integral. You can see that inside the square root of this thing, we can use a Pythagorean identity to simplify it. But there's a really subtle sine issue that arises, and it involves the absolute value function. So what we're going to do in this video is just churn through it and ignore the absolute value and see what goes wrong. And then we'll go back and think carefully about how things have to be adjusted, and we should be able to get a sensible result out of the integral. So to begin with, we're going to apply the identity. Sine squared x equals 1 minus cosine squared x. And this means the inside of the square root reduces to the square of the sine function. Now what I mean by proceeding naively through the integral is that we could just say the square root undoes the squaring function. And again, I'm working through it this way to illustrate how it gets us into trouble to be that casual about the square root of a square. And there's a couple ways to argue what happens next. I could guess the antiderivative and evaluate across the endpoints, or I could say, look, the sine function spends half of its time above the x-axis and half of its time below the x-axis on each period, and I'm integrating on exactly one period, so I know this has to come out to zero. If you want a little more formal argument, I guess the antiderivative, evaluate across the endpoints, and when I plug in the upper limit, I get a negative 1. Then I subtract what I get when I plug in the lower limit, and I get 0. And then I have to ask myself, does it make any sense that this integral came out to 0? If I go back to my original integral, that square root inside the integral is always non-negative, and usually it's positive when the square of the cosine is less than 1. So how can I possibly integrate a thing that's usually positive and never negative and come out with 0? This is impossible, so something has gone wrong. And where it's gone wrong is back here, where I said the square root of the square of the sine function is just equal to the sine function. That's not quite right, because the square of the sine function is always positive, and then when I square root it, I'm guaranteed to get a positive result. The square root of a square of a thing is just the absolute value of it. In other words, it erases minus signs, just like the absolute value does. So really what I'm looking at here is the integral from 0 to 2 pi of the absolute value of the sine of x dx. And so the absolute value is going to leave the sine function alone, provided the sine function is non-negative. And that happens on the interval 0 to pi. So we're going to split up the integral. And then the absolute value function multiplies the sine function by negative 1 in order to make it positive whenever it's negative. And that happens on pi to 2 pi. Now we can guess antiderivatives and evaluate across the limits of integration. And when I plug the upper limit into that first term, I get negative negative 1. That's positive 1. And then I subtract negative cosine 0. So I'm adding cosine 0, and that's a 1. In my second half, I get the cosine of 2 pi, which is 1. And then I subtract the cosine of pi, which is negative 1. Okay, so this turns into 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, and that is 4. And that makes a lot more sense than saying this thing is equal to 0. So just to wrap things up here, I popped in a picture real quick of the square root of 1 minus cosine squared x, and I shaded in the area represented by the integral that we've just computed. Now clearly this thing is not 0, and if I check to see how reasonable 4 is as an answer, I put grid spaces on this graph, and you can see that in the first bump I have about 2 total spaces. In the second bump I have about 2 total spaces, and so it looks like 4 is a reasonable answer for this integral. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.